And as always here in Lubbock, the wind should come into play. And Kevin Kortzman has us underway. This is going to be Dudley McAfee, who decides not to field it. It is a touchback. And you notice right off, I'm sure, the red jerseys and the black pants. Boy. This being the home finale this regular season, they have decided to change up their color scheme a bit.
Well, it was interesting. They came out and warmed up with the black jerseys. I was just as surprised as you were to see them.
And Jamie Gill, again a quarterback, near perfect to Texas last week, including the game-winning touchdown to Anthony Mannyweather, with him in the backfield. As we mentioned, James Gray, and he's just 32 yards to get his second 1,000-yard season. Winston, the fullback. And you saw the receivers, the offensive line led by Odierne and Richburg on that left side. They break the I formation on first down. Gill almost stumbling on play action, has a day and a half. And the wide side of the field is open. But he's chased down and picks up only about 3 yards as Darryl Davis, ultra-quick defensive end, a senior from Midland, right there, 6'3", 257 pounds, makes the tackle. With him up front, Washington, Wyatt, and Collins. The linebackers in their 4-3, Booker, Smith, and Cobble. And in the secondary, Gallabies, McWright, Crump, and Campbell. So from the 23-yard line, the Raiders second down and 7 yards to go. They have both their wideouts on the left side. They would prefer to run the ball a vast majority of the times today. And Gray powering up near the 29-yard line. That'll be close, but not quite for the first down. Gallabies brought him down. Good block by Richburg. As you look at Gray's numbers this year, Texas Tech musts for this afternoon. What are they?
Well, first of all, avoid another letdown. They seem to have that big game and then all of a sudden have that letdown. Capitalize on the turnovers. They should create the turnovers and be able to capitalize on them. TCU has been very guilty of that, and have James Gray gain over 100 yards. That has really been a statistic that we'll look at when he gains over 100 yards rushing.
They rarely lose when that happens. Third and call it two. They try Gray, and on second effort, he has the first down up to the 36-yard line. A fine block by Travis Price to get him around that corner, and Lavoil Crump made the tackle on the senior from Fort Worth.
You know, emotions play such a big part in it. I don't doubt that the red jerseys were saved until the last minute. And I'm sure that's part of Spike Dykes is just trying to get his team motivated. Look what James Gray has done against TCU. That is unbelievable. 6.3 yards per carry. That's his three prior seasons.
However, TCU has had an outstanding running defense this year, and they've shut down some big backs. On first down, a floater well behind the tight end Kevin Sprinkles. And it was a near interception for Ed Gallabies. Not a well-thrown ball into the wind by Jamie Gill.
And that's an important point to bring up about your TCU defense here, Dave, is that they have played the run very, very well. We saw what they did against Air Force, and Air Force came into their game with TCU, and they were highly ranked as far as running the ball.
They were top ranked.
Yeah.
And only because of what the Frogs did, they held them to about 230 yards, are they now behind Nebraska. Mannyweather in motion on second down. He'll play action. This time the pressure is there. And at the 27-yard line, he has coughed it up. And a TCU recovery.
Wow, does that play a big part? You do not want to give a team like TCU, when you're supposed to be the favorite, and you can see Jim Wacker there, you don't want to give him the ball in this field position. But Gill just gets a little sloppy here. The ball gets pulled away from him. He falls backwards, and they just cannot cover back over top of it. Good charge there by TCU. Well controlled.
Fred Washington stripped the ball, and Darryl Davis made the recovery. So a turnover-prone TCU sees how the other half lives. Giles under pressure from Rowe and throws to his offensive lineman as the flag goes down for grounding. Jody Morse, number 52, the center, was the nearest Horned Frog to that toss.
Yeah, that's definitely going to be that's a critical play right there. You just can't make a mistake like that. Giles under pressure just wanted to get the ball down. What you ought to do is just throw the ball down 15, 18 yards downfield.
As they march it back on the intentional grounding call.
Intentional grounding, offense, 5-yard penalty, loss of down.
Boy.
Offensively for TCU in the triple shoe, Giles Jackson, Palmer Holmes, and Foray late starting additions at wideouts. Elliott, Sullivan, Morse, Bronson, Alexander, they have really scrambled an injury-plagued offensive line today. Giles, after play action, has the open man in the middle. And the catch made by Alan Foray, a senior from Midland. He's brought down by Ronald Ferguson. And that will help the TCU cause after the penalty mark-off. Defensively for Tech, Washington, Perry, Hennington, and Mathis Meyer, as has been the case all year, the front four for them. The linebackers, Weatherspoon and Derryberry, who starts for Wingo. Matt Wingo with a turf toe problem. Ferguson, Walker, Dubisky, and Saul, a secondary, seeming to come into their own as the season wears on. Third down and 8 for Ron Giles and the Frogs, and it is Tommy Palmer dragged down by Charles Perry.
Boy, who else would you think on that front line except Charles Perry? He has just had a marvelous season. Number 74, 65 tackles. He's been in on the sacks. He's had tons of pressures, and he plays his position really well. Controls his guard, plays off him, tackles for a loss.
So Kevin Korsman will go for a school record. If he makes it, that's 8 straight field goals. His last miss was in the opener at Missouri from 52. This is a 41-yarder. He has the win behind him. And he's got plenty of leg, but he is wide right.
Oh, well, that's spur up your defense. When you stop him, you give him the ball, your offense turns it over, your defense comes over, and look at the defensive coordinator. Just saying, that's the way to go, guys.
So the end of the street.